sort of trying to figure out the placement of different objects, I would firstly use tape because this is not really permanent. So if I go like this and I stick this on, it's just there. And if I want to take it off, I want to move it somewhere else or whatever, or let's say I want to use, actually what's even more interesting is using the silhouette. I want to use the back of his head. Then I can play around with it before it's permanent. And if you want to have it be permanent, then that old school trick, which is paste on one side only, will allow you to perhaps be able to take it up again and place it somewhere else.
Is that the glue stick we're going to use?
Yes. Permanent? Yes. So otherwise, you're going to put the glue stick, you can sort of like maybe trace where this is going to be, or you don't even really even have to do that. I can just put glue stick here and glue stick here, and as long as there's two sides, it's going to stick. And once it's stuck, it's stuck. If you try to pull it up, it's going to rip. So just make sure you're pretty sure about where you want it to go. Okay, so that's another thing. And then basically what I can do is I can just keep going through this and, you know, maybe see, okay, well, what else can I put in here? Again, you can use that big figure drawing as a base, or you can cut it in half, you can cut the figure out of it. So there's a million different things you can do. The key thing is just to find something you don't want to cut and have that be your underneath, or you can cut it.
And can we use that, the board we have, or will that work? I don't have it.
No, no, it's worse. Oh, well, if you have scissors, then
it doesn't matter.
You can just like puncture a hole.
Yeah.
And do it that way.
Yeah. So if you're like layering it, and in the end, you're going to stick it all together as one.
So at the end, I'll show you. You don't have to stick all of it together. You're sticking part of it together.
Oh, okay.
So the actual sheets. So, like, for instance, these two things, this and this, do not need to be stuck together, necessarily, unless you want everything to be totally flat.
Oh, because it will give it, like, texture?
Yeah. If you don't, if you go like this,
oh, I see.
Okay,
yeah.
If you just tack it,
yeah,
then it's more sculptural. Okay, so you can see some of the shadows coming through the holes. So yeah, so you don't have to mess. So, but like this, you want to stick on. But and any other thing that you want.
So that
be,
so permanent. So you then you like basically you have to cut out some of the pictures and layer them on there and give it that. Is that what you have to do? Or you know what I mean? Like you have to cut out, or can you just cut like little sections?
You can just, no. You can just cut little sections.
Oh, okay. I'm just wondering.
Yeah. I mean, you don't have to. Yes. You don't have to go crazy. Sections is fine,
yeah.
And then also I can add things. So
yeah.
As I'm doing this, so this is another layer.
Yeah.
And actually, this layer I'm going to have be sort of like a small. I'm not even going to have this be a full size sheet. But I can add things too. So let's say this is starting to get yet another layer on top. Maybe this will only go here. But then what I can do is I can take my pastels and go back, and I can also use for reference still life objects. So I'll put a little bit of, I'll put a still life object. pictures, the landscape photos, we can use some of that as reference too. If when you were looking through your pictures and you're like, you know what, I really want something that I don't have, I kind of want like a landscape or something like that, then you can go ahead and use a landscape picture and make a landscape and cut that out. So you can make some of the parts in here as well.
Oh, so not just our works, we can use the magazine pictures.
You can use it as reference, not cutting it.
Oh. So we have to start again.
No cutting my magazine pictures. Yeah, I get too long to amass that collection, sorry.
Yeah.
Here, but if like I need, like for instance, if I wanted, rather than cutting out still life objects, I wanted to cut out landscape pieces, and I've already used like my two landscapes that I have, and I don't really want to cut up the other one, then I can make a whole new landscape to cut in order to use as one of the layers for this. So you can either use anything in your pad to cut up, or just like make, you know, kind of like making new stuff. So here, let's say this thing is underneath, but I want to continue this on. I want to continue this orb, whatever it is, on top of here. Like, and this kind of connects this to this in this sort of strange way. This. And this is just me kind of making up these things as they go. I like this idea of just having it be a process and then lending itself to the final. So this is starting to take things from underneath and pull on top. This, you know, if I have a still life object in front of me or something like that, it cuts something out that emulates. Still life object is there. It's just or just to kind of, you just change the texture.
Can you put I'm not saying you should do it, but let's say you just put the water right on that.
That's going to, the water on the butcher paper doesn't.
But if it was on another paper, can you put, I'm just asking, you don't have to do it.
Yeah, no, I'll try it. Okay,
I'm just wondering.
Here. Sort of gives it,
kind of
yeah.
Bloody look there.
It gives it just a solid, yeah. And then you can pretty. Sort of take it from here and use almost more of a watercolor. So you just have to play around with it a little bit. Just do it lightly though. Don't do it too hard because it can go through the paper. And this is just one more element that's kind of fun.
Yeah.
And then it also kind of crinkles the paper a little bit, so it gives it a different type of texture. Okay, so then this. would basically be my final piece. And then when we hang it up outside, we just put like two or three tacks and then allow for each layer to be separate so that it can act more